Hello friends, let us now see the software VMware. This is my VMware workstation. Let us discuss about VMware workstation. Here you can see this is VMware workstation application. VMware application is used to create virtual operating systems. I will show you here. You can see that this is the menu bar and you have different options here. If I click on this option, it will show me all the created VMs. So here I am able to see that I have a VM called as Cassandra, Cloudera, Cent, CentOS, SA. These are the different VMs I have already created. Here is another icon. If you click on it, you will be able to see the VMs below here. So here you can see this is one VM. If I click on any VM here, so it displays the another VM. So it is like all the tabs. Here SA, here CentOS, so all the tabs, they will be visible here below as well. Now let us try to create a new VM. This is the home screen. From here we can create a new virtual machine. In order to create a new virtual machine, we need to click on create a new virtual machine. After clicking, you will find this screen. Please observe that I am using Workstation 11. You might be using a different version of Workstation. Accordingly, the screen, the UI, may get changed, but the options will remain same. Here we have two choices, typical and custom. We have to select the default one, typical. Then click on next. Then we have three options. One is installer disk. In this case, we need to insert a disk. Another is installer disk image file, that is ISO. And third one is I will install the operating system later. So in this case, it is like we buy a CPU and CPU is having no software installed. So this is like that. So virtual CPU will get created with the amount of RAM and CPU cores and hard disk allocated. So we want to install CentOS 7. So I will click here, the installer disk image file, and you can browse. And after browsing, you need to select the operating system which you want to install. So I have CentOS 7, this operating system's ISO file. I will click on it and click open. As soon as I click open, I find here CentOS 64-bit detected. This operating system will use easy install. So if there is some corruption, there is some error, you will see the message here itself. So in that case, you need to basically test whether the file is corrupted, and if it is corrupted, then you will have to download the CentOS file again. I will click on next now. Here you have to fill your full name, username, password. For now, I'm keeping everything simple. So let's say I keep everything as Hadoop. So I have kept username and password, everything as Hadoop, and I'm clicking on next. Here you need to give a name to your machine. Again, I'll give name as Hadoop itself. And you can change the path where the machine should get created. So all the files related to this machine will get stored in this particular path. I am keeping it default. I am clicking on next, and here you can see by default 20 GB has been allocated, and you have option like store virtual disk as a single file and split virtual disk into multiple files. So in our case, you can basically choose any of them, because that is not going to make very difference, because we are installing the virtual machine for practice purpose. I'm keeping this 20 itself and I'm going forward by clicking on next. Here you can see summary of all the configurations we have done. If you want to change the configuration, you can click on customize hardware, and here also you can basically change the configuration. CPU, you can see that only one is there. Memory, 1 GB is there. So let us give 2 GB of the memory. Network adapter is NAT. If you want, you can change it. You can make it BRIST. And other settings, if you want, you can change. I will click on finish, and you can see that after finish, it will directly power on this virtual machine after creation. So let me finish. So now you can see that it has started the setup and it will install.